Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Welcome to Salem Lutheran Church on this beautiful Sunday morning. I think we're still in August, but the lack of light and the cool temps makes me question everything.
So I'm not sure, but it is so good to be here together in worship this morning. Thank you if you're joining us on Zoom or later on YouTube. It is a pleasure to be holy and Christian community together once again. A couple of brief announcements. First, thank you to our musicians, to Mark and Janine, and to Kirsten for leading us in song and praise today. To Shannon and trainee Mark in leading our tech today as well. And to so many others for leading bits and pieces of worship together. Everyone after worship is invited to join downstairs for fellowship afterwards, down in the fellowship hall that's down. And if you go upstairs, it's immediately to the right down those stairs or to the elevator and then around the corner and straight into the fellowship hall. All are welcome for that. It is time to sign up for the state fair. So Rachel Carmichael will be either in the narthex or probably more likely wherever people are down in the fellowship hall to help get people signed up, answer questions. It's an online sign-up system, but she is happy to do that manually for you if the online system is not what works best for you. And a heads up, if you are in one of the planning capacities on the state fair, we have our state fair committee meeting today at 6 here at church. I don't know any other details besides that, but I want to make sure we state that so we don't forget it, because time is of the essence. Any other announcements from the community to share today? Wonderful. Well then, let us turn to our bulletins as we join together in our opening liturgy of confession and forgiveness. Gathered together in grace and in mercy, we confess the ways we have fallen short of God's commands to love each other as individuals, communities, and systems. Beloved, God sees you fully and forgives you completely. God grants you new life to love and serve in joy. Thanks be to God. Amen. Now we'll join together in singing our gathering song number 674 in your red hymnal. And this one, stay seated if you'd like, but if you are comfortable standing, do whatever makes you comfortable.
This is a more upbeat song. Turning back to the bulletins, let us pray to
together our prayer of the day. And we pray. O God, judge eternal, you love justice and hate oppression, and you call us to share your zeal for truth. Give us courage to take our stand with all victims of bloodshed and greed, and following your servants and prophets, to look to the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The reading is from Luke today. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed. For the mighty one has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich empty away. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his descendants forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand as you're able for our affirmation and gospel reading.
Jesus said first to his disciples, "I came to bring fire to the earth, and how I wish it were already kindled. I have a baptism with which to be baptized, and what stress I am under until it is completed. Do you think that I have come to bring peace to the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, 5 in one household will be divided. 3 against 2 and 2 against 3, they will be divided. Father against son and son against father, mother against daughter and daughter against mother, mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and daughter-in-law against mother-in-law." He also said to the crowds, "When you see a cloud rising in the west, you immediately say, 'Oh, it's gonna rain.' And so it happens. And when you see the south wind blowing, you say, 'There will be scorching heat.' And it happens. You hypocrites, you know how to interpret the appearance of earth and sky, but why do you not know how to interpret the present time?" The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Beloved siblings, grace to you and peace from God, our Creator, and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Okay, y'all, Jesus is on one today. He is filled with passion. And I suppose if I were to choose one of my favorite Jesus moments or Jesus ways of being, it's a passionate Jesus. But texts like this sometimes make me think twice about that. If you think about it, though, the type of passion that Jesus brings is not a surprise. You see, in my experiences with love, And I think particularly parental love, being a child, growing up, the most intense forms of love that I experienced were from my parents. And when I violated their trust or did things that were just ridiculous, some of the most intense anger, and thankfully for me, not violence, but anger, was also from those same parents who loved me so deeply because they cared so much about me and they wanted so much for my well-being that when I did something to threaten that, it scared them and frustrated them to no end. Jesus is bringing both that same intensity of care and love and passion and anger in this text. For God's people have not lived up to the covenant and the promise and the identity that God has set before them and that they have the capacity to live up to. And God's anger in Jesus is kindled. Fire is the first image that begins in this text. And when I think about fire, well, I get, bear with me, a little excited. I love fire. Not always in the context of this text, but I was the kind of kid growing up who would just like stare at fire for hours, freak my parents out sometimes. I still can get lost in a campfire or a fire in the hearth of a home. I think candles and the fire and the glow that they emit are utterly beautiful and bring peace and fascination. But when Jesus says he comes to bring fire to the earth, my fascination with fire is on its heels, and I think we can't help but be a little afraid. Because when fire is set loose on the earth, that's when things, trees, homes get burnt down. This is the kind of fire that I remember growing up seeing firsthand, or at least its after effects firsthand, up in the Boundary Waters Canoe Area Wilderness. We went every summer. And though we were a city family, we loved camping and the Boundary Waters especially. We went towards the end of the summer every year with another family for about 10 years straight, getting to know the land, each other, and this other family deeply. And a couple of those years, the routes we took us right through recent forest fire paths. And I will never forget the way that the land had just been scorched. The land itself was gray and ashy, and what used to be beautiful towering pines and some deciduous trees and bushes to fill in between them was laid bare. Sometimes the trunk of the pine would be remaining and be all craggly and jagged, and sometimes it was absolutely flattened. The fires cleared out the brush, the undergrowth. Sometimes the things that were good also got swept up in the fire. But I knew, or was taught, that this fire made room, created nutrients even, for new growth to occur. When Jesus comes and says that he has come to bring fire to the earth, this might indeed be a fire that burns up all of the brush, the undergrowth, the things that get in the way of the big and beautiful, holy, kingdom-like plants and trees from growing. This fire has come to clear out systems of oppression and violence and hatred. This fire has come to clear out unhealthy competition and greed. This fire has come to clear out all abuse and oppression at the hands of power, including religious power. These fires are going to burn hot. And so much of this world will be caught up in their flames. I told you, Jesus was on one today. All that will be left of these systems and structures and powers and principalities will be ashes. But much like the Boundary Waters after forest fires, God can do something with ashes, with dust. If you remember, life itself was created out of the dust in the Genesis story. God tenderly pays attention to the dust and gathers it up and forms it into something and breathes life carefully and powerfully into that dust, into that ash. And God creates something beautiful from that ash. So it will be with this world of ours, once its systems and structures of oppression and violence have been burnt to a crisp and laid bare. What was a kingdom of might will then give birth to a kingdom of forgiveness. What was brush filled with fear will grow into powerful pines of courage. What was these big structures of power over others will be transformed into humble structures of power alongside each other. This process, just like growing anything in my experience, is not going to be easy or comfortable. Because we tend to cling to what we know. So we will tend to cling and surround ourselves and hold on to those things that are being burnt up right in front of our eyes. And then it is hard to tend to new growth. The new growth, whether it is grasses, trees, vegetables, or flowers, or whether it is the kingdom of God itself, it requires work and labor and care. So while some cling to these old ways, in the face of the burning fire, there will be division. There will be people who refuse to get on board with this new kingdom, and that will create a separation, and it will not be easy. But we mustn't value the division without talking about why division might occur. We're not trying to lean into being separate and being divisive. Instead, we know that when this new kingdom is being given birth to and it is growing, that we're not all going to be on board. And it's going to be hard. It already is. And warning here. If the new kingdom that is being burned and if the things that get burned up or the new kingdom that is being birthed and the things that are burned up tend to align exactly with your political beliefs, tend to align exactly with our political beliefs, Pastor Eric, we're getting it wrong. This is not a call for us to think that we know what's right and to accept division with those who think that we are wrong or that we think are less than or wrong. This is a statement of God's power and God's intention for a new kingdom that Mary so beautifully sings about in the Magnificat, that had been promised to Abraham and was formed out of the dust itself in creation. So Jesus embodies this fire and speaks of it to his disciples and the crowd gathered around. The fire is coming. These systems and structures of the powerful and the haughty and those who are rich, well, they're not long for this world. Soon they will be but ash, the fire doing its job. And the fire's job will continue. And a structure and system that values the poor and lowly and fills the hungry with good things is coming. So the question is, what is your relationship to the fire? Are you one who is called to tend to it and help direct its flames towards those systems and structures that need to crumble? Or are you one to follow it close by, letting the fire do its work until ash is in front of you, and to join with God in tending to the ash and caring for it and putting it together and breathing life into something new and beautiful and holy and good? How are you called to be in relationship with this fire? This fire of destruction, this fire of creation, this fire of God, this fire that most surely is coming. Thanks be to God for that. It is beautiful. Alleluia, alleluia. Amen. Continue with prayers of the community and world. Each petition will conclude with "Merciful God, please reply with 'Hear our prayer.'" And the last full petition will be one that we will open up for any prayer concerns you might have to share aloud, to hold in your heart, to put in the Zoom chat, or to share with your neighbor. Trusting in God's extraordinary love, let us come now to be near to the Holy One in prayer. Arise, O God, and sustain your creation. We thank you for all that you have made. Every one of our siblings, the animals, the plants, the water, and every part of this planet. May we root ourselves together in connectedness, living with respect and reciprocity. Merciful God, hear our prayer. Arise, O God, and sustain your church. We pray for all who dedicate their lives to serving your people. Renew our commitment to our siblings in faith all around the globe, and bless the work of our ecumenical and interfaith partners, especially Watchmen Outreach Ministries, our Northside Lutheran Parish, the Minneapolis Area Synod, the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, the Lutheran World Federation, and so many more. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Oh, hear our prayer. Arise, O God, and sustain the nations. We pray for all elected officials. Kindle in them a desire to administer your justice. Strengthen their resolve to defend those who are vulnerable and to stand publicly against all forms of oppression. Merciful God, hear our prayer. Arise, O God, and sustain those who are experiencing said oppression. We pray for people harmed by racist discrimination, ableist discrimination, and people discriminated against based on gender, identity, or sexual orientation. Rescue us from all systems that degrade our fellow human beings. May your fires of justice burn against those systems. And may you, and may we by your side, create something new and life-giving and liberative for all people. Merciful God, hear our prayer. Arise, O God, and sustain this assembly. We pray for Salem. Be with our state fair leadership team and all our volunteers as we count down the days until we begin. Celebrate with those who rejoice and watch over those who travel. We trust that you are weeping with those who weep for any reason. Be with everyone in need, including Sonia, Sharon, Jeanette, Marsha, Rob, Marion, Lorraine, Mark, Christine, Alex, Vivi, Henry, Susan, Anne, and all those people we name before you silently in our hearts or spoken aloud at this time, or put in the chat as well. Merciful God, hear our prayer. Receive these prayers of your children, merciful God, and hold us forever in your steadfast love. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And now, beloved, the peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share a sign of that peace with one another.
Say hello. They can say hello.
I'm learning.
You're part of the team. Welcome. Peace.
Looks like Susan is just out here changing her hair. Yeah.
be with you.
Computer does a lot of strange things. It just pops up weird things. They need to update the software. Virus protection sometime. And they haven't done it. So we get little pop-ups every now and again.
What do you need to control?
I
just
need 150 password.
Ourselves, our time, our relationships, and our possessions. Use us and what we have allowed in feeding the world with your love. Through the one who made himself Christ, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. In a moment, open the tray of Lord Jesus to bread and take it. So broken, and we give it to his disciples, saying, take and
yeah, we could read
this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me.
Please, Ben.
And then again, after supper, you can come.
Okay.
Blessed be your thanks and give him all to bring us saying this on his covenant, my God. And for you and for all the world, for the religious do this for the
world. It'll pin for the whole world.
If
he wanted to, we could pin him, but that means he's going to pin us for the people who are already looking at him out there, because that is only for us to
So let's pray. Our Father, who art in
heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is
the kingdom, power, and glory,
forever and ever.
As usual, we'll commune by coming forward, giving the sent child, the leading receiving, he comes out of the bread, we could have forgotten the option as well now. And then take a last small amount of last line by your red line and talk outside. Let's turn a little order. I'm going to read the truth from the inside of this section. And then I'm going to go back to the other side. Please, please, God, and see if you can there will also be community distribution music. Please join in that. Probably wait to receive communion or start trying to receive. Table is over here.
Sometimes I'll just place it on the congregation and put the mic on the music. Because if you try and put the camera on the musician, you just have
Thank you.
here. So we'll just go. Actually, just go through here.
Yep, you can switch to camera.
Yeah. And the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthening and keeping you in His grace.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Susan must be working with her.
God of abundance, with this fresh life of salvation, you have
turned it yet.
May you give us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
And now, again, everyone is invited downstairs after worship in the fellowship hall for some time of fellowship and celebration. And before this final blessing and sing song, Tompkins family, I know you're online. May your sanctity be a traveling verses to you as you depart for your time,
your sabbatical time as a family, beginning tomorrow as you begin your travels.
May the Lord bless you and keep you.
May the Lord's face shine on you with grace and with mercy.
May the Lord look upon you
with favor and give you peace.
May the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, Mother of us all. Amen.
Final blessing will actually be a host of that. This will be the final blessing.
Even better.
So now,
the fruit of all creation.
There you go. And the morning is the recognition. Sounding good.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
right here. Okay. So sometimes somebody will get crazy and they'll disconnect. Well,